happening is you think about safe way to climb up or have accessibility on the challenging areas around building or structure. So if scaffolding built proper way, you can work very, very safely in there. It's basically a platform, if it built correctly, installed correctly by a professional staff that has a good safety procedures of building and implementing it and inspecting it, you'll provide a very excellent working conditions. And I think we found this probably the most efficient way without constantly removing or adding, where you can actually set it up and continue to do the work until the work is done. You can safely take it apart. So that's, in our way, is really a scaffolding will be like a safe way to do the job. Because there's other methods as well, but I think this takes more time initially, but actually will save a lot of times in the long run, because you don't have to constantly, like pump jacks, move it up and down, or ladders move it up and, you know, all these, and that's kind of a little shaky. So I don't think the guys feel as comfortable. Here is really, you feel stable. The guys also build themselves, they inspect themselves as well. We obviously inspect it as well. So this way, you know, everybody knows it's safe and keep it out on a daily basis that it's safe to use. And it really truly helps us to do our job right. So we want to have and make sure that we have a sufficient space, safe space, to be productive and do the right job. So we decided the best option is just to purchase scaffolding and assemble it and make sure it's done correctly. And we're not pressured by anybody to, oh, there's another monthly payment coming up, or you got to do this, you got to wrap it up, you know. We want to make sure it's done right on our terms. So this way we don't rush with safety, we don't rush with the procedure, and when it's ready, then we can move it ourselves. Well, obviously it starts from ground up. So I want to make sure that surface is properly prepared. There's some uneven surfaces, so we want to level it out, or we want to do some digging to stabilize it. We want to have a solid base, because we don't want something, you know, be depressed in the ground later on, because obviously rainy season is coming. So what we have now might be different later on. So we want to have pretty wide base underneath the scaffolding. And then once we start building up, we want to make sure it's level. We choose the position where it's best, closest to the building, and we can work properly and set up properly. And start basically assembling. Obviously, it requires about 2-3 people, so one person holds it, another one adjusts it, so we kind of make sure the right guys have a proper training for that. And basically, go from all the way up. Once we get a couple frames, a couple levels, we want to make sure that it's properly attached to the building and keep going higher. We always tell the guys, hey, every time you climb on the scaffolding, really take a look how things are set up, you know. So obviously we do pretty often an inspection of it, but as a general rule, anytime you climb, especially on a ladder, you want to make sure the bolts properly secured, the nuts all the way tightened up. So you don't want anything loose on the scaffolding, you know. If you notice anything out of place, do not use it immediately, bring it to attention your supervisor and start correcting the issue. So I want to make sure that scaffolding, sometimes, you know, you have to rechange some of the connections to the wall, and due to the work performed, so you want to attach the other point how the anchor is secured, the scaffolding to the building. And so not any point, you want to make it a little less structurally, well, say safe to use. So for each crew has a supervisor, you want to make sure that everybody's engaged in a safety process. You know, things can fall off the scaffolding very, very easily. So maybe somebody passing by, so you want to make sure there is some guards against that. You want to also make sure that you maintain your scaffolding, you clean it up, you know, you don't put things close to the edge, you don't put things that necessarily have to be there. So there's other areas for that. So whatever you bring the stuff, you want to make sure that it's not going to disturb the balance of it. So you want to make sure that it's kind of, you know, common sense, obviously, and good training, constantly be aware of it is a proper way. So our supervisors will kind of inspect it with the guys, and we'll have different crews go to each other, scaffolding as well, to kind of look for different things, make sure everything's properly and kind of point it out. Because as you become in your daily routine, sometimes you don't notice, like, hey, there's too many screws here and there's some lumber here that really, you know, you can easily just knock it down and fly over. So same thing for the guys that walking around, they have to be aware. We don't want it, but what if? What if something falls, you know? So you want to be constantly aware if there's a danger, and this platform is there to, you know, help us do the job. We don't want anybody to get injured to that. So I want to be kind of aware of it and kind of walk away from it. And keep an eye on it. You want to be always be aware who's working the scaffolding, what level, what's going on, what part of the job is doing, are going to have any beams or 2x4s. So you're kind of aware of the process, and you know what to anticipate.